Welcome to the course on computer networks. In this video, we are going to talk about the second design issue of data link layer, which is framing. Framing plays important role in data link layer protocols. The motivation behind this topic is how to define container for packets received from network layer for a point-to-point link or between nodes on a local area network. Figure shows host 1 and host 2 as a sender and receiver. The responsibility of data link layer is to collect the packets from the network layer and to convert them into the frames according to the specifications of underlying physical layer technology. Framing is breaking a bit stream of packets into the discrete frames as per the specifications of physical layer technology. Therefore, the goal for this topic is to define frame structure for data link layer protocols and break bitstream up into the discrete frames at source and make packets from these frames at destination. This overall process is called encapsulation and decapsulation process. In the encapsulation, data link layer converts packet into the frames at sender side, and in the decapsulation process, receiver converts frames into the packets. Key points to remember: the container for data at data link layer is called frame. Container for data at network layer is called packet, and the container for data at transport layer is called segment. The information available at application layer is called as a data or information. What is frame? A frame is a digital data transmission unit for data link layer protocols. Frame consists of following three fields: header, payload, and trailer. Header is start of the frame, payload is actual data to be transmitted, and trailer is end of the frame. So here we can see that data is covered by header and trailer. Header and trailer are acting as a delimiter for the payload. There are four methods available for making the frames: character count, byte or character stepping, bit stepping, and multi-bit encoding. The first method is character count. It defines the frame format as header and payload. It uses the header to specify number of characters in the frame, including header byte count. Whenever frame is received by the destination, destination sees the character count and knows how many characters follow after header and where the end of the frame is. Example shows frame with 6 characters, including header count. So 6 is the value in the header field, and it is followed by 5 character data. Let us look at the additional examples. Figure shows there are 3 frames of sizes 4, 6, and 8 characters. The problem with this algorithm is that if any error occurs during the transit and it changes the header field, then it becomes very difficult for the receiver to know the end of the frame. For example, second frame consists value 6 in the header. If this value gets changed to 7 during the transit, then destination will get out of the synchronization. There is no way of telling where the next frame starts. And due to this reason, this method is rarely used anymore. Second method is byte or character stepping. This method helps to get around the problem of synchronization in character count method. How it does it? It uses the special bytes at the start and end. The frame format for this method have total 5 fields: flag, header, payload, trailer and flag. In the past, the starting and ending bytes were different, but in recent years, most protocols have used the same byte at the start and end. These bytes are called flag bytes. They are the delimiters for indicating start and end of the frame. Second figure shows that there is a frame having payload as ABCD, that is 4 characters. So frame is made of the 5 fields having 2 flags at the start and end, and 2 more indicators are there, STX and ETX, where STX indicates the starts of the payload, that is start of text, and ETX indicates end of text. So payload is always surrounded by STX and ETX, and frame is having flag as a start as well as end delimiter. For this method, receiver never face the problem of synchronization. Whenever it loses synchronization, it just search for the flag byte to find the end of the current frame. 2 consecutive flag bytes indicates end of the one frame and start of the next frame. Let us look at the additional examples. It may happen that the flag byte bit pattern may occur as a part of data. This problem is solved by inserting a special escape byte ESC just before each accidental flag byte in the data. We have 3 examples, and in all 3 examples, the payload consists of either flag or escape character itself. Payload for frame 1 is A flag B, where flag is the delimiter for start and the end of the frame. Therefore, this flag is prefixed with a special escape byte. For the second frame, payload is A escape and B. So escape is a special character. So to take the care of this character as a data, it is prefixed with another escape character. Third frame shows that both the escape and flag bytes are the part of data. So to treat them as a data, 2 escape bytes are used, and due to it, data is A escape, escape, escape and flag. 1 escape character is to care the escape as a data, and second escape character is used to take the care of flag. A major disadvantage using this framing method is that it is closely tied with the 8-bit characters. This method don't allow characters to have arbitrary number of bits. Third method is bit stepping. This method solves the problem of 8-bit character encoding of earlier method. Bit stepping allows data frame to contain an arbitrary number of bits. Character code can have any number of bits per character. Because of this, this method can be used for the Unicode, where number of bits per character are varying from language to language. For this method, each frame begins and ends with special bit pattern 0 followed by 6 consecutive ones followed by 0. If 6 consecutive ones are appearing as a part of the data, how to solve the problem? So to avoid flag as a part of data, this method uses a technique where whenever there are 5 consecutive ones in the data, it automatically stops a 0 bit. Whenever receiver sees 5 consecutive 1 bit followed by 0, then it disturbs next 0 bit. Following is the example. There are total 5 fields in the frame, 2 flags acting as a delimiter starting and ending. Header and trailer are surrounded by the payload. So flag is 0 followed by 6 consecutive ones followed by 0. Header, trailer and data in the form of binary bits. With bitstrapping method, the boundary between two frames can be unambiguously recognized by the flag pattern. Thus, if the receiver loses track of where it is, all it has to do is scan the input for flag sequences, since they can only occur at frame boundaries and never within a data. Examples. We know sender inserts a 0 bit after 5 consecutive ones in the input data. So in the first example, there are two streams of ones having more than 5 consecutive ones, and hence 0 bit is stopped 2 times in the payload. For the second example, there are 8 consecutive ones. Therefore, after 5 consecutive ones, 0 bit is stopped. In the third example, there are consecutive 16 ones, and therefore 3 zeros are stopped after sequence of 5 consecutive ones. What is the outcome and how this framing is implemented over the field? The data link layer breaks the bit stream up into the discrete frames according to the physical layer technologies. It computes the checksum for each frame and transmits it. The checksum is recomputed at the destination to detect the errors. If checksum is different, then frame is discarded. Receiver sends back an error report in the form of negative acknowledgement. This negative acknowledgement indicates that there is a need to retransmit the same frame again. Over the field, time gap is inserted between the frames called inter-frame gap, IFG. This gap is important for the packet switching technology, so because this gap allows the internetworking devices to decide on the outgoing lines. Character count method is very simple and it is not used anymore. Byte stepping is used in bisync, DDCMP and PPP protocol of internet. Nowadays, we use point-to-point protocol to get connected to the internet at logical link layer. Bit stepping method is used in the protocol X.25 HDLC, ADCPP and LABP, where LABP is a protocol of ISDN. Thank you for watching this video.